Treatment of back pain. Most acute back pain gets better with a few weeks of home treatment. However, everyone is different, and back pain is a complex condition. For many, the pain doesn't go away for a long period, but only a few have persistent, severe pain. For acute back pain, over-the-counter pain relievers and the use of heat might be all you need. Bed rest isn't recommended. Continue your activities as much as you can tolerate. Try light activity, such as walking and activities of daily living. Stop activity that increases pain, but don't avoid activity out of fear of pain. If home treatments aren't working after several weeks, your doctor might suggest stronger medications or other therapies. Medications. Depending on the type of back pain you have, your doctor might recommend the following. Over-the-counter pain relievers. Non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, such as ibuprofen, Advil, Motrin IB, others, or naproxen sodium, Aleve, might relieve acute back pain. Take these medications only as directed by your doctor. Overuse can cause serious side effects. If over-the-counter pain relievers don't relieve your pain, your doctor might suggest prescription non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. Muscle relaxants. If mild to moderate back pain doesn't improve with over-the-counter pain relievers, your doctor might also prescribe a muscle relaxant. Muscle relaxants can make you dizzy and sleepy. Topical pain relievers. These are creams, salves or ointments you rub into your skin at the site of your pain. Narcotics. Drugs containing opioids, such as oxycodone or hydrocodone, may be used for a short time with close supervision by your doctor. Opioids don't work well for chronic pain, so your prescription will usually provide less than a week's worth of pills. Antidepressants. Low doses of certain types of antidepressants, particularly tricyclic antidepressants, such as amitriptyline, have been shown to relieve some types of chronic back pain independent of their effect on depression. Injections. If other measures don't relieve your pain, and if your pain radiates down your leg, your doctor may inject cortisone, an anti-inflammatory medication, or numbing medication into the space around your spinal cord, epidural space. A cortisone injection helps decrease inflammation around the nerve roots, but the pain relief usually lasts less than a few months. Education. There's no commonly accepted program to teach people with back pain how to manage the condition effectively. So education might involve a class, a talk with your doctor, written material or a video. Education emphasizes the importance of staying active, reducing stress and worry, and learning ways to avoid future injury. Physical therapy and exercise. A physical therapist can apply a variety of treatments, such as heat, ultrasound, electrical stimulation and muscle release techniques, to your back muscles and soft tissues to reduce pain. As pain improves, the therapist can teach you exercises to increase your flexibility, strengthen your back and abdominal muscles, and improve your posture. Regular use of these techniques can help keep pain from returning. Surgery. Few people need surgery for back pain. If you have unrelenting pain associated with radiating leg pain or progressive muscle weakness caused by nerve compression, you might benefit from surgery. Otherwise, surgery usually is reserved for pain related to structural problems, such as narrowing of the spine, spinal stenosis, or a herniated disc, that hasn't responded to other therapy. Alternative medicine. A number of alternative treatments might ease symptoms of back pain. Always discuss the benefits and risks with your doctor before starting a new alternative therapy. Chiropractic care. A chiropractor hand manipulates your spine to ease your pain. Acupuncture. A practitioner of acupuncture inserts sterilized stainless steel needles into the skin at specific points on the body. Some people with low back pain report that acupuncture helps relieve their symptoms. Transcutaneous electrical nerve stimulation. A battery-powered device placed on the skin delivers electrical impulses to the painful area. Studies have shown mixed results as to transcutaneous electrical nerve stimulation effectiveness. Massage. If your back pain is caused by tense or overworked muscles, massage might help. Yoga. There are several types of yoga, a broad discipline that involves practicing specific postures or poses, breathing exercises, and relaxation techniques. Yoga can stretch and strengthen muscles and improve posture, although you might need to modify some poses if they aggravate your symptoms. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to my channel. You can consult me for online, chat, audio, video, consultation. Contacts will be in the description for the video. Take care. Have a good one.